What are the chances of a rebound in commodities over the next 3 months? I wouldn't bank on it.
Well, what does commodities thrive on? They thrive on growth, they thrive on demand, and not too much supply. At the moment, we have too much supply and we have growth, which is not really picking up pace, especially if you look at China, where we have seen weakness over the past several quarters. And that's obviously having a negative impact on commodities, and we see that continues into the second quarter as well. Much obviously depends as well on the dollar. The dollar has been on the rise for a long time. That has also put some additional pressure to commodities. If we do see a bottom here, which we probably don't see at least for the next quarter, that could add some support, but that's probably first into the second half of the year.
So one of Ola's essential trades for the second quarter is to have a bullish exposure to precious metals, and he's especially looking at selling the gold-silver ratio. Here's why.
Well, we just got trillions of dollars looking for a safe home at the moment because we got several key bond markets trading at negative interest rates. That is pushing that is pushing investors towards alternatives. Obviously, stock markets are still doing very well, but there is this new opening for alternative investments, just like gold. But I'd like to exclude the dollar part of it because obviously I think the dollar could potentially still rise, and that's obviously negative for precious metals. So I like to look at gold versus silver. If we see a growth story coming towards the second half, silver could potentially do better than gold, and that's why I like to be short gold, long silver as a ratio.
And to oil, and while Brent crude appears to have found a pretty solid floor around $50 a barrel, the short-term outlook for WTI is not so promising. And Ola is looking to short it.
Rising supplies of crude oil in the US will continue over the coming months. That will continue to put some additional pressure to the spot month. But as we're looking for a recovery later in the year, we could see this spread between the spot futures month and the 6 months out start to widen even further. So this contango, as it's called, I see widen even further. So that's why I'll be selling the June WTI and buying the December WTI.